What's up, what's up, what's up, y'all? Welcome back to the show. My name's Kalisha. This is The Playlist. We got special guests joining us today, JackBoy. Let's hope Instagram lets us save the live today. I'm just saying. But anyways, going down, if you're just tuning in, JackBoy joining us. He just dropped a brand new song exactly almost a week ago, Spitting Facts. His latest project is self-titled JackBoy, which has a lot of dope records on there. But I'm really feeling this new record that he dropped, Spin Facts, and we're going to talk about it. If you haven't heard it, the lyrics are deep. The song is deep. So I got a few questions about the lyrics and the song itself. I'm going to ask him, where did he learn how to dress? Because that boy can dress for real. So I'm going to go ahead and play his record right here, Spitting Facts, so y'all can get a vibe for it. You pay up one another, bitch, you getting wet. Yeah. Spinning nigga, other shit right off the mat. Listen to these lyrics. It's crazy. In a home for you to see him from the jungle. All these cars, you could tell I had a rumble. And I push it out, and get it off the muscle. It'll be 18, but hoping that you fall. Yes, sir. JackBoy joining us. He's from Florida, but he's actually was born in Haiti. A lot of people don't know that, but you know, I did my research, so I do know that he was born in Haiti, and he just joined us right here. If you just joined, we got JackBoy joining us. His latest single right here is Spitting Facts. Let's go ahead and bring him on in. What up, man?
What's up?
How are you?
I'm good. How you doing?
You just hopped off a flight. Are you tired? What?
You say what?
You just hopped off a flight, right?
Yeah, I just got off the flight.
So where were you coming from? You shooting a video or something?
I was coming for hanging out, you know, the second crib, the bay, out there in the bay.
Okay, I see you. First of all, I just got to ask you, who the hell taught you to dress? Because you could dress as...
You say who taught me how to dress?
Yes, because you fly, okay?
I mean, fly.
Okay, don't have that outfit then.
Yeah, this is...
For real, who taught you how to dress, for real? Because you
I like putting that shit together. Like, I like looking at shit, like going in the mall and just picking shit out, stuff like that. Like, and doing a little different from like what's norm. Like the all white pants, like I don't wear that, or all black pants. I'd be like, that ain't swag. You gotta throw something else in there. It's too normal.
Right, because you're like, it's like everything to the top, to the pants, to the shoes. Like, it's
extracurricular.
All socks. It's all put. Can we see the shoes? What shoes you wearing? Let's see the shoes.
I got them on.
Let's see. Oh, see what I'm talking about? See what I'm talking about? You are fly, man. Come on.
Yeah.
But let's get into it. Nice to meet you, Kalisha. So shout out to everyone tuned in. What are these Z's about? I didn't know about this until now.
Or the Z's, that's just a zombie world, and they telling them stop sleeping on a nigga. That's what that mean.
Hey, what do you think is the song that most that people sleep on the most that you got?
All my music.
No way, really? Why do you feel that way?
Cause it's like certain stuff. I feel like it got a lot of views and it's doing big, but shit, it could be doing bigger. You still sleep, man? How come a billion motherfuckers ain't see this? Fuck. However much million, I want a billion motherfuckers to see this, or y'all still sleep.
I heard that. What's up with the billion streams? But listen, you're on Spotify. I just looked at it. You're almost at a million monthly streamers.
Yeah.
That's a big deal.
Uh-huh.
What you mean people sleeping on you? A million people is a lot of goddamn people.
Yes, that's all right.
Numbers on the back end at one given time, how many people are listening to your music at one given time on Apple and Spotify?
I ain't check it, but he was telling me it was good. I just drop it and it's like whatever happened, it happened. A lot of songs bring me back a lot of money, and some songs don't bring me back nothing. But it'd be like, all right, I'm just, you know what I'm saying? It's something to do instead of going out there trying to thug it. So it's like whatever come from it, it's like it's all a win because I never wanted to be a rapper. So it's like
no way. Yeah. You never wanted to be a rapper. So how'd you get introduced to the rap game?
Kodak.
Okay, how did that happen? Like, let's talk about, for those that don't know, was it just y'all were homies, y'all were friends? He was doing rap stuff.
See, he was rapping on the street. And I kept on, like, saying, like, probably dumb shit, like, robbery shit, speaking shit like that. But we never, like, spoke on it until one time I seen my name. He just made XXL Freshman. Then wow. I seen my name in there. He said, they asked a question, like, who should be here that's not here? Like, what artist should be here that's not here? He said, JackBoy. They said, where can we find his music? I ain't had not one song out. He said, you can't. And then, but just chill, you coming. He was like, he got a drive just like me. So that made me like, you know what? I fought with that. I'm gonna start rapping. So he really got me in the door with it. Like, man, you know what? Fuck that. Let's rap. But that shit like probably 2-3 years ago.
Yo, that's love. That's love. A lot of people don't do that. They don't put people like that. That's XXL. That's a big deal.
That's a huge deal.
That's a big deal for real. So you met Kodak from just kind of hanging around him, you know, you said, seen all the stuff that you saw, and you went away here and there for a couple of times. What keeps you going doing music after facing all that drama that you face?
See, I was, the drama, like the jail part, that should be hard, but crazy to say, I kind of had got used to that shit. That shit was like normal to me, like, because right. It's like, I've been getting locked up like 11, 12, all that. But it was always 21 days, some bullshit. But at 13, I got locked up. And I did from 13 to 17. So that shit, yeah. So that was like, damn, I'm kind of used to this at 17. So I came home at 17. I was out for 1 month. And I went to Virginia and did some other shit with Kodak. And they sent me to prison this time. So I went to prison for 2 years. At 17, I came home at 19. I was out for like 9 months. Then I went back to prison for 2 more years. It was like, none of the time wasn't really hard because I always knew, like, I got something. I know I'm finna be something. I just ain't know what the fuck I was finna do. Then it was, like, all that time I was plotting. And then I was plotting, like, all right, what the fuck am I going to be? If I'm going to be a robber, I'm going to come out here and be the best robber because I got 2 years to think about that shit. So I was like, nah, I ain't going to do that shit no more. Yeah. I'm a rap. I'm going to take this shit serious now. Since the platform already here, it's, why not? So I was like, all right, I'm gonna be a rapper. So that whole time, that whole 2 years, I was plotting on a dumb ass. Know what I mean?
Wasn't, I mean, you was doing interviews while you was in jail too. I seen that.
That gleeful. Hey, I'm that gleeful. Cause when I walked in jail.
That's crazy. Like, I didn't even know that existed.
Yeah. When I walked in jail.
I didn't even know that existed. Like interviewing. Your internet keeps going in and out. We back?
Yeah, we back.
But like I was saying, like that's different. Like I've seen that being done before. But that goes to show you who you are and all the noise that you were making.
Yeah, see, I went, and my situation was crazy. They really did it because I got out. When I got out the second time from prison, I was only out for like not even 24 hours.
Wow.
So, y'all posted, they didn't tell me I had another warrant and another. Everybody want to call me.
Internet trash. Nah, his hotline bling is popping, okay?
Hey.
But go ahead.
So, now, I came home for one day. He steady called. Hold on.
This happened with Shadow.
I don't know, but I think if somebody ignore it the first 2 times, you should just fall back. Hey,
like, come on now.
Yeah.
Tell them what you were saying.
The interview. Hey, but yeah, so I came home. They was supposed to never let me out, but they ripped it. They let me come home. So I came home for one day. I went to go see my probation officer, locked me back up, all that dumbass shit. So that shit was kind of big. That shit kind of like, hold on. People, that wasn't supposed to go on. Pretty much, that was it. So when I got there, I walked in. They like already knew who I was. They're like, oh my God, Jack Boy. I'm like, fuck it. They like, you want to do it? They news want to do an interview with you. Fuck it. Bring them in here.
Yeah, come on. Let's go. How did that play out after, you know, the inmate, which like y'all like, oh, he really famous. Like people coming up in here doing interviews with him.
On that interview, I capitalized. That's what I'm good at. And then I know how to capitalize on shit. That's how I became a rapper.
Right.
So in that interview, I knew it was gonna get seen to, it was on the news, and I knew it was gonna get seen to audience that don't watch Jack. You know what I'm saying? Nobody that look at Jack right now don't be watching the news for real, for real. So it's like, all right, I'm going to get that there. And now I got other people tapping in on me. I got, like, mayors wanting to be homeboys. Like, come on.
Hey.
But so it was like, it got me in the door on some other shit. And just for, like, in the end, when it's all said and done, I could capitalize more and become even bigger.
Right. Do you think it's really hard to get support from people in your own city, like as far as radio goes and fans and all that? Or did you find that?
As far as my city, that's the streets. Listen, it's a lot of rappers. We got a million rappers that's raw in my city that's trying to get the streets. Listen, they trying to have hold of the streets. I don't want the streets. I want states. Then after I get some states, I want the countries. So I don't give a fuck about nothing, how they feel or what's getting played around here. Does that?
Right. That's smart.
Bitch, play me in Arkansas. Then after y'all done in Arkansas, send my ass to Paris. Nothing, fuck what's going on, right? I seen you motherfuckers all my life. I don't give a fuck.
Damn right. Yeah. That's so. Do you have a huge fan base in Paris or internationally? Is it still building? Did you have plans to like tour overseas before all this Corona situation?
I definitely didn't have plans to tour overseas because I'm on probation and like with this music. Like I said, I just started really taking it serious, but now like. The person, like Empire, they really getting me into a lot of different shit. And then, so I'm talking to guys on a lot of shit like that I'm going to get into. And people going to start seeing it happen. If quarantine wasn't going on right now, nigga would be that lit. It would be super turnt right now. But it's like, we're going to wait after that. But that's definitely a plan to go overseas with it. And then I'm still on probation. But my judge, all that, they cool. They willing to let me go however. They don't really trip on me or none of that shit.
That's good, cause you being good, right?
Yeah, I be chilling. They know I'm a calm person. They know I don't just do bad. You know what I'm saying? I might do some fuck shit, beat this person up, but it was all the reason behind it. You know what I'm saying? It's like he jumped out there on Jack. So they don't really be too pressed or like what's going on. Really don't be too. It's like all right, you know I'm doing what I'm supposed to.
Right.
You know, I'm making money the right way.
Exactly. So I'm glad you kind of brought that up because I was listening to Spin Facts that you just dropped last week. And I looked at the lyrics because, you know, I'm from L.A. You got a little country accent going on. So I had to look up the lyrics. And I noticed you mentioned two names. You mentioned Michael and David. Are those two real people, like real homies?
Them twin brothers. That was
so
one. One of them, my co-defendant, he was on the case with me. And he told on me. So Kodak said one of his songs, Kodak said I fuck with Michael Lane, but his brother on rap. I still can't believe twin told on Jack. So now, in my city, loving this right now, they eating it up. Because they know these names and these big, these supposed to be big gorilla OGs, these niggas. 6'3", 6'4", 240 pounds. Fuck you. Still pussy. You still told something. Man. Fuck you. However. So now, I say, he told on me on my case. But when we in jail, he trying to play it like, all friendly shit. Like, I ain't telling her. But I never took my case to trial to for you to come in there and point at me. I took a plea for downward departure.
Mm-hmm.
So now, his brother got into some shit in the streets and told again. His brother told now. So I'm like, man, fuck Michael and David Lane. They both jumped on the case twin rats. Yeah, you niggas identical snakes.
That's insane because, listen, I come from the suburbs. I don't know nothing about none of that, okay? Yeah. Like, telling me all this police stuff and this and that. I'm learning, okay?
Yeah,
that,
yeah.
That he would do that. Like, people is really snakes out here, for real.
People really 6'9" in it.
That's some real life shit. Real life. So let's say fast forward, these two dudes came back and were like, yo, like, I'm so sorry. There's like, that's the
It ain't no sorry. It ain't no sorry. It ain't no sorry. And the type of character them two dudes is, they that mad. They'll probably try to be on some gorilla, gorilla, but they don't want to be gorilla, gorilla. Because, you know, gorilla, gorilla got a lot of gorillas.
Yeah, they be fronting. A lot of these dudes be fronting. Hey, all cap.
Yeah.
Capping.
Then when you go to jail in Florida, you beefing with them Haitians?
We want none of those problems. You Haitian yourself, so tell us about them Haitians.
Shit, we raw. We that gleeful. We amazing.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. You remember what it was like to live in Haiti? Because I know you came out to Florida at 6, right?
Yeah, a little bit, but but not really. But mm-hmm. I still remember. It's still, and it's parts of Florida that low key you might feel like, but this is Haiti right here.
Right. There's a big community.
Yeah, I don't think I ever lost like the culture or like the vibe or like everything that they still doing in Haiti, I still do here. Mm-hmm. Except for just other little shit.
Right.
As far as the same food, as far as the language, we still speak it every day. And then as far as the lifestyle, as far as the compa, we still doing all that.
Yeah. So you speak the language.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Tell me something. In is it Haiti? What's the language? Haitian?
You say what?
What's the name? What do you call the language?
No, it's called Creole.
Creole. So tell me something. Mm-hmm. Tell me something in the language.
A bitch say Haitians don't like to pay a nigga. Hell no. But you right, too. He know a Haitian. He know a Haitian. He say Haitians don't like to pay a nigga. He know a Haitian.
Mm-hmm. Tell me something in the language.
Kile wap kitem fwape.
What does that mean?
When you gonna let me love you?
Oh, that's cute. I speak Greek. So, se agapo. That means I love you.
Oh.
Hey. So you gotta have a culture, okay? So my mom is, my dad is Sri Lankan. Have you ever heard of Sri Lanka?
I never heard of that. What's that?
It's an island off the coast of India.
What is it called again?
Sri Lanka.
Mm-hmm. Look, now I'm on it. I'm hip now.
There you go. Do you know any other Sri Lankan?
I never. It's my first time here in Sri Lanka.
You probably don't even know that they're Sri Lankan because they look like they're Indian anyway, like red dot Indian.
Yeah. See, I would have probably thought you was. I don't know.
Like mixed. I get mixed all the time. And then when I have my hair braided, I get, are you mixed with black, white, black and mixed? Yeah. I get all types of stuff. But listen, I'm me. I'm okay. But anyway.
Right.
I want to talk about your collaboration with Travis Scott, because that's how I learned of you. Because I work at Power 106, so they was, you know, bumping. So how did that happen?
Mm-hmm. And you know what's crazy? The JackBoy that they using, this a whole different vibe. Yeah, this a whole different. Yeah, this a whole different Jack.
It is. So what made?
Yeah, that's Cactus Jack. This JackBoy.
Huh?
I said that's Cactus Jack. This JackBoy.
What made you switch up the vibe?
Shit, down south.
Down south, the vibe of mm-hmm. it.
Hell yeah.
So who are you currently listening to? If this is,
huh?
I said, who are you currently listening to?
JackBoy, Kodak, Kevin Gates. I listen to Kevin Gates. I listen to, I listen to a couple people. I listen to Lucci, some of his songs. I listen to whoever making real music that I could vibe in the car and chill to. I'm not on that, oh, fuck his music. But some people music, I don't know, they get no play on the arts.
Yeah, no, I feel you. I feel you. Do some artists will say, "Oh, I don't listen to certain artists because they influence me into an artist that I'm not." Do you feel that way at all?
Influence?
Yeah, the sound or the music.
Nah, I don't look at that. Like, oh, like they music might influence somebody. Your music?
Yeah, exactly.
Regardless, nothing under the sun is new. Mm-hmm. So the sounds they using that they think they making, that shit been used some way, somehow. You probably just perfected it, doesn't it? So it's like, yeah, I'm going to listen to your music. And if you got some raw shit and I could do it rawer than you, you better tighten the fuck up, because I'm going to sound that much better than your ass, doesn't it? Exactly. I'm not going to listen. You know how rappers do. I'm not going to listen. Nah, you play around sound that much, I'm going to sound better. But I don't look at it like, oh, I'm influenced by his music. Because I'm spitting my life. I feel like if you spitting your life or whatever you got going on at the moment, is like, it don't matter what he's saying. Because I'm going to give it a different way. We both could be talking about the same situation, but I'm going to give it a different way.
It's the vibe that you bring to it, the way you let people relate to it and understand who you are.
Yeah.
That's dope. Who do you want to collaborate with in the future?
Right now, I ain't even gonna do that, because how Instagram is set up and these rappers, these niggas so faggots that you say right now, I'll collab with this artist. 2 months down the line, he's gonna try to diss you and be like, you said I was gonna. So you know what? Nigga, you can collab with me. You gotta ask them who the fuck wanna collab with JackBoy.
Period.
Send a little resume. I'ma look it up. And if you meet the qualifications, I'm gonna jump on your shit. Other than that, it's people I will collab with. But I'm not too pressed, because I ain't got time for you niggas be on funny time. Nah, I ain't on funny time with no nigga.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Do you think a lot of these artists really about like that funny stuff? They really ain't about what they talk about?
They definitely is. They definitely is. The industry funny. It's like, even if they is about what they talking about, they fall to the point where they don't become about what they talking about, because they so dick riding and so politics. Like, right now, if I fuck around, not even me, my homeboy that don't even got one song that never even rapped, if he go drop a song right now and go number one, you going to see all the biggest rappers in his DM. Like, get off a nigga's dick. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's mm-hmm. all they do. But say that same homeboy that they just said, my brother, my twin, or whatever the fuck niggas be saying, he say he fall off or something. They don't know you. Mm-hmm. Now they with your enemy on his dick. Like, man, come on, man. Stop sucking dick.
That's real. People just hopping on them bandwagons, right?
Man, they try to catch a wave. As soon as they see a little wave coming, they try to catch a wave. Nigga been DMing you 3 years ago for a feature. Don't jump on my wave now. Fuck that. Your wave done dried up. Man, your ass on your way back to the beach. I just got on my jet ski. Your ass going back to the beach. You out of gas.
Yeah. Now that's real shit. I couldn't have said it better. You put it in perfect words. But before we wrap it up, I want to have a little fun with the interview and ask them, you know, little fun questions, make people laugh a little bit. It's called This or That, all right? So yeah. I saw you smoke weed because I was on one of your lives one day and you was talking about the weed man is not allowed to go to sleep. You there?
Yeah.
You got someone calling you again, huh? So you was talking about the weed man isn't allowed to go to sleep, right? He was like, that's just wrong. I saw that live. Yeah. So I want to know, if you couldn't smoke weed for a year, so this or that, you can either not smoke weed for a year or eat some booty. Which one you picking?
First of all, I gotta smoke weed. But if it's Rihanna or Beyonce, I'm jumping out there regardless. Nastage.
Okay.
Who the fuck? If Rihanna say eat that ass, play your ass, eat that ass. No, I ain't gonna lie. I might not eat the booty. But I'm smoking my weed. I'm smoking my weed. It's Oprah, hell yeah, because Oprah could buy me a new tongue.
Okay, period. Would you say Oprah. New tongue?
I'll eat Oprah ass.
Did you say a new tongue?
Hell yeah, Oprah could buy me a new tongue. I'll eat Oprah ass.
That's hilarious.
You better eat Oprah ass too.
Listen,
she got $1 billion.
Maybe. Maybe. Shit.
All right, since you want to ask me a question, I got to ask you a question now.
Ask me a question. Let's go.
You went sexual, so, hey, you open that door.
Let's go. Come on. I keep it real.
You smoke?
I don't smoke.
What you do, drink?
Yeah, I drink, but, like, socially. And I promise I'm lying.
Would you rather keep on doing this job you doing? Or not get dick for 5 years?
5 years?
That's a sentence. That's a jail sentence.
Fuck yeah. I never went to jail in my life either.
So what you picking?
All right. Hold on. I got to think about this. Would I rather keep the job that I got or not get dick for 5 years? I'm keeping the job because I need my bills paid, all right? Like,
so you don't get dick for five, but dude.
Honestly.
I know how to pay bills.
Can I suck dick and eat my pussy?
Oh, yeah, he could eat your pussy and you could suck dick. Hell yeah.
Oh, so I always be sucking. My pussy
I know how to pay bills. Hell yeah. You don't even got to worry about the job. I know how to pay bills. You heard me?
All right. What about this? What if I choose to not have the job, get the sex, and he's paying my bills?
That's JackBoy. Yeah.
Hey, shit. JackBoy paying bills? Come on.
That's JackBoy. Ain't no...
You funny. All right, next question.
All right. What's up?
I'm dead, yo. Okay, next question. All right, since you from Florida, or kind of sort of from Florida, are you wearing permanent nails or a permanent gold teeth or a grill?
Permanent.
Permanent. Yo, did that hurt?
I had golds already before permanent gold. Probably the permanent gold the first time, it kind of felt weird because it was a new feeling, but... We warriors. No, that don't hurt.
So how do you eat? Like, I always wondered that because I saw Lucci took out his and he, like, posted a picture. And I never knew about permanent growth before.
Yeah. I eat the same way. At first, like, say, like, the first 3 days, it might feel a little weird because it's a new feeling. And I got, like, they got diamonds on the front of theirs. And they only got 10 teeth. A lot of people. But I got diamonds on every single teeth, and I got it on the back where you can't see it at the inside. So it felt weirder because I never, your tongue feeling that, like it feel weird at first, but now I'm used to it. I don't notice.
How much did that cost?
Huh? And I'm going to break it down for you how people be lying. All right, say if you get it every teeth, I'm going to give y'all the cheat code. If you get every tooth, you could get it for like, it depends the after you get the gold, the diamonds put on it, you could get it for like a stack of tooth, it depending. But, and you could pay a little more too. But say if you got 30 teeth in your mouth, that's where it come up. Mm-hmm. Then the diamonds is, say some teeth require more diamonds than the other. So mm-hmm. Now getting on the front and back is making it more. And let me give you the sauce on niggas. I be exposing niggas. Niggas go to Johnny Dang. And say they paid 30 racks. No! No! Because somebody told me if I go to dude, he'll do 10 on 10 for 16 bands.
Mmm.
Niggas ain't tutorial.
Mmm. See, the first time I heard about Johnny Dang was from one YBN. Almighty Jay. I didn't know who the hell that was.
They getting their 10 on 10s for like 16, 17 bands.
Wow.
Everybody that got 10 on 10 from Johnny Dan was like 16, 17 bands with promo. You got to do promo. That comes with it. All of them. Everybody. Whoever went to Johnny got 10 on 10. It was 16, 17 bands. It was not 30 bands. He told me the same thing. I got the same DM you got. Know that?
Right. Wow.
I just went to Florida. So I could 60 on Lumpy. I be flossing when I'm floss now.
Hey, that's why you be pulling your finger, huh?
You see, they gotta do it like this. When they do it, they gotta do it like this, cause they don't got that much teeth. My mouth look weird, cause I'm way back here.
Right.
I'm way back here.
You showing people what's good, like
yeah,
that's even the veneers are the same way too. Veneers are, they only be doing it in the front. Then they got their normal teeth back here.
That crusty.
Mm-hmm.
Mouth crusty.
Mm-hmm. And some dentists don't even do it the right way. They be leaving people all like weird. If you look at their gums, you gotta zoom in. I'm not gonna put anybody on blast, but Moneybag Yo was one of them. Okay? Moneybag Yo was one of them. I'm sorry, but my friend's a dentist and he put him on blast on his page. He be doing like Offset's teeth and everybody, like DJ Darrell, Monique, all the Love and Hip Hop. But he's one of them. I didn't put on blast, he did, okay?
No, was I fought with Bag though. Bag his show's hard.
Cool, but his dentist is the problem.
What his dentist is?
Dentist is the problem. I'm just saying. All right, let's move on, okay?
Did my dentist do good?
It looked like it. It looked like handsome. You look good. You look cute. You too young for me, though. Come on.
I'm too young. Stop playing on me. I'm a grown man. I'm
27.
You 27?
In August, I'll be 27.
What that mean?
And listen, our birthdays are right around the corner from each other. I'm right. August
23rd. You're August 23rd?
Yeah, I'm the 23rd.
So you're celebrating in Florida this year, right?
You said I'm celebrating what?
In Florida this year, right?
Bad idea, actually. I'm supposed to be going to Florida on Tuesday.
Put love. I'm down here. We live. We're going to hang out. Chop it up.
Oh, it was good. We'll link up for sure.
Real shit. We got it. I'm going to hold you to that now.
I'm filming a series down there with somebody. I'll tell you who it is offline, but it's gonna be dope. It's gonna be real.
I might jump in right quick. Who knows?
Yeah, who knows? Listen, we can make some moves. Come on now.
We definitely gonna make moves.
Oh.
We're listen, definitely making moves.
What's good? Mm-hmm. Okay. Questions for you. We keep getting sidetracked. All right. You was talking about alcohol. What you drinking, light or dark?
Dark.
All right. You love your designer clothes. You pick in Fendi or Chanel?
Chanel.
Okay. I think you answered this earlier, but you do an online shopping or in person?
In person, online, too bullshit, too complicated, and that'd be too high.
So you send people to shop for you?
No, I don't send people. I like to get out there and physical. You know what I'm saying? Because you might see somebody you don't like and get to hit them in the head right quick. Nah, I'm definitely.
We're talking about the features. If you had to pick one artist to feature with, get a feature with Jacquees or Chris Brown?
Why you even? You can't even put Jacquees in the same sentence as Chris Brees. Stop playing with him.
Interesting. That's what makes it interesting.
Nah, man. You ain't even give Jacquees a chance to win.
Okay, you
didn't give him a chance to live. You know I'm a. He not even living against Chris Brown, man. Give Jacquees a chance to live.
Tory Lanez or Jacquees? Let's switch
You're
it
not
up.
Even giving Jacquees a chance to live. Jacquees a chance to live.
Clearly.
Man, you got to do Jacquees versus YK Osiris or some shit. You can't do Jacquees versus Tory Lanez or Jacquees versus fucking Chris Brown. Nah, man. He raw. He raw, but he not. Come on, man. Chris Brown. Come on, man. Chris.
Is that how Chris
that shit they be doing all this shit in the video? That's they got that for Chris Brown. All this and Chris Brown got it from Michael Jackson.
Definitely. He definitely paved the way for show.
Yeah, they you know what I'm saying.
You got some dance moves popping or what?
Hell yeah, I got some dance moves.
Little something over there.
You wanna see?
Yeah, let's see. Come on.
This my new dance move. I just don't know what to call it.
Hey.
Yeah.
A fucking dance move.
I just don't know what to call it.
The bump is crying, goddammit. This has been one of the best.
Best interview in the world. That's what it is.
This was fun. I'm glad we were able to do this.
Yeah, real shit.
But listen, before we go, let the people know what we can expect from you that you haven't even put out there yet.
This song's so hard, I'm going to tell them about it.
All right, come on.
Me and Rollo Rodriguez got two songs that ain't out yet. Man, when them shits drop, oh my fucking God.
Okay.
But shit like that. But we working. You know what I'm saying? We working. And I'm going to give him something else. Maybe June or July. I'm going to give him another one.
Okay, you coming back to back with it.
Man, I got too much songs just recording. I'm steady recording and learning shit.
Okay. Huh? I think you Florida boys ain't playing no games. Y'all about it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yo, thank you so much for hopping on here with me. If y'all haven't already checked out the latest single, out Spittin' Facts is fire. Definitely Spittin' Facts. Talked about it. Check out the interview. When I drop it on the page. If y'all didn't know what my name is, Alicia. Come on.
1804 Jack. Well, already. Free Kodak.
I'm going to talk to you soon. Take care.
Real soon. Real soon.
All right. Come on. Hit me with the follow. Let's go.
I'm talking like right now.
I'm going to talk to you soon. Bye, y'all. Bye, Jack.
Already.
Thank you.